good documentary can obviously tell the story, and you become known for this historical stuff. This is history, but not really, this particular story.
We've done a film called The Central Park Jogger, and it is about a crime that took place on April 19th, 1989, and that's right at the cusp of where I'd say history sort of begins and journalism leaves off. And I'm always really worried about that cusp, because you want to be able in history to triangulate all the various perspectives that you have and not be making perhaps facile or superficial journalistic judgments.
So, I mean, the story is the Central Park Jogger. We definitely remember the story of the, you know, when they found this woman's body. She had been brutalized, and they had picked up these kids.
There had been a whole bunch of kids who had poured into the northern portion of the park and sort of gone through and were making mischief. And in fact, some serious crimes were committed by somebodies in this group. But as the cops scattered them, they gathered up a few, couple of our men, and later on collected some others. And then later, when they discovered the jogger's body, it suddenly, understandably, said, oh, it must be them.
Right.
And they never let go of that original aha moment for them, even though these kids had no idea where the crime had taken place, that they were in another part of the park, their DNA was not connected with it. There was nothing of this horrible crime scene on them and nothing of them on the crime scene. They still used all the police tactics, hours and hours, upwards of 30 plus hours with these children, two 14-year-olds, two 15-year-olds, and one 16-year-old, to sort of extract, look, we know, George, you didn't do it, but there's a guy named Ken. You say, who's Ken? He's in another room, he's saying you did it. And after a while, you're going, if you just say that you saw Ken do it, we'll let you go home. Well, of course, they're all just tight in the news. But nowhere along the line did anyone in a position of power, the media that ran with this, these were wilding wolf pack predators. It's the language of lynching from Jim Crow, not the language of a progressive modern city in the late 20th century.
Donald Trump weighed in buying ads, telling him he wanted people to, like, even he was part of the hysteria, right?
There was, he wanted the reinstatement of the death penalty.
Right.
Patrick Buchanan, a conservative columnist, said they should take the oldest of them, meaning Corey Wise, who was 16, and hang him in Central Park as an example to everyone else. And so,
just the imagery that he paints, it makes me think that Pat Buchanan, maybe, I want to believe he doesn't understand what it's like to say, let's lynch this kid in a, you know, but maybe he does, that which would be even worse.
You know, it's so funny. We as a country, we as a world, as a population, have struggled with this question of racism, you know, and what it is. And it's the horrible, metastasized flip side of an understandable thing, the love of one's own. And but when that love metastasizes, then it's always the suspicion of the other. And usually it's skin color that makes the determination. Sometimes it's sexual orientation. Sometimes it's what country you're from, what sex you are.
Socioeconomic status.
Exactly. So we're always making distinctions about the other and forgetting to extend to them the courtesy that we wish to have, which is our basic humanity intact. And that's what happened. It was so easy to tie it up in a nice, neat bow that no one ever stopped to think that these five black and Hispanics were actually human beings that lived lives as full as you and me, and that they could have been caught up in a tragedy that was unavoidable. They actually knew who the guy was who did it 2 days before, because he'd attempted another assault, the sociopath that was responsible. They had his DNA, and when they eventually caught him after several more crimes, including a murder that could have been averted if they'd followed through on the original crime, no one ever bothered to check. So these kids go into the system, they go into jail for upwards of 13 years, only to have, when the last one gets out of jail, the actual rapist confess. And then 13 years later, you have this new tsunami of information. But institutionally, the cops, many of the ADAs, the assistant district attorneys, and the media, who had been responsible for the fury of this sort of lynching, wouldn't take responsibility. So instead of being the number one story for days, it was buried. And 10 years later, almost 10 years later from their exoneration, the city is no closer to resolving a civil suit that the five, Central Park Five, brought, and more dug in and resistant to the facts.